since the there are a couple of channels pumping this out, and there were a ton of comments on Jordy's live stream yesterday asking about it. I'm just gonna take a look at it real quick. As far as I can tell, it looks like an internet hoax. I think more interesting to this conversation is that Jeffree Star was just banned from live streaming, not from posting to his TikTok account, which is why he was able to upload some makeup review videos and stuff like that during his ban. But he couldn't do any live streaming. And I think that was a very significant punishment for him, because it sounds like, based on his return to the internet, that he is not going to go to this Live Fest event, because he was asking other people that he was battling about the details of it. So obviously he has not received any email inviting him. And I don't think Eugenia did either, because neither of them seemed to know the actual details of this event. And upon Googling it, I don't think it's open to the public. So it's not like it's out there for you to buy tickets to watch it happen or anything like that. Which is an interesting choice, TikTok, but okay. So anyway, let's take a look. This is a very short video, but I just have some thoughts on it. Especially given that upon his return, he was just as smug and bitchy, but not as angry, right? He wasn't raising his voice, and at least in this the clips that I've seen. I didn't watch his entire live stream comeback, but I saw some of the stuff that Jordy captured last night, and I saw the stuff that Eugenia Cooney Shorts, I think it's called, the channel, saw what they captured. And Jaded has this. Jaded also is the first one I saw circulating the alleged obituary. But I just don't even know what to do with that. It looks like an internet hoax. We've had that happen so many times. I mean, look at how many times they reported Betty White was dead before she actually passed. You know? Look at what happened with, I think it was Tom Petty. They reported him dead 24 hours before he actually died, right? And this has happened before. And usually these types of memes that get circulated through social media are connected to a virus or a phishing scheme or something. So you gotta be super careful with this. But anyway, let's watch this. Starts fumbling.
We're using my new pink powder. Comes out very soon. It's very soft.
Is it just me? Is it just me? Is this sex so good? I should not.
I'm not sure how they get to play background music like that without getting copyright issues when they're on TikTok, because I always get slapped with copyrights, even when I'm just singing karaoke. But anyway, upon his return to the internet, or to TikTok, live specifically because he didn't lose his posting ability. He said that he believes in freedom of speech. He believes that his freedom of speech was taken away and that he got punished for having opinions, when in fact he was breaking the terms of service and spreading fake news, which is especially going to be treated with bans during a presidential election year. That's going to be a much bigger deal when we're about to start the first primaries. So it matters. You know, what are you putting out there, and how is that going to influence the electorate? That's really important. But secondly, it's totally hypocritical for him to talk about freedom of speech. You hypocrisy! It's totally hypocritical for him to talk about freedom of speech when he was actually a mod on Eugenia's channel. And so not only was he helping her boot people who asked any questions about her health, but there was one night when they were doing a battle in which Jordy's name was coming up so many times from his own fan base in their chats, because he was sniping them that night, which is basically he was live streaming their live stream, right, at the same time. So it was simultaneously happening. And a lot of the users in Jordy's live stream went over and started essentially trolling them with, like, joke comments and stuff. And the first thing they did was make it members only. So I don't think that you have a very good argument, Jeffrey, for saying that you are in favor of freedom of speech and that you felt like your freedom of speech was taken away, if you're going to mod comments and you're also going to go to members only mode when you see somebody's name that you don't like, right?
Is it just me? Yeah, is it just me? Is this sex so good I shouldn't have...
What is going on with the two of you? That both of you... Okay, your hair looks like crap. For real. I mean, first of all, you have roots. Second of all, the area that you did bleach out looks like it's gonna break. It looks like you probably put some greasy product in there to try and keep it from getting too dry and brittle, but it looks terrible. And the last few live streams that I saw Eugenia do, her hair looked greasy as hell too. Like, what's going? Are you guys kind of like breaking down? Like, what's happening to the two of you?
Okay. Another one. Face is set. Don't play with it.
He was reading comments, then he does something on his phone. Did Jay even know she hadn't been active?
Oh, I see there's a lot of questions in here asking about one of my friends. What questions do y'all have about my friend? What questions do y'all have about my friend? There's a name I'm seeing pop up a lot on here. What questions do y'all have about my friend? I know there's a lot of negative people in that talk about my friend a lot, and there's a lot of fake rumors. But yes, Eugenia is okay. We talk every day. Me and Eugenia talked this morning. She's at home. Of course I've heard from her, y'all. We're real friends off this app. She's at home. So if there's any fake rumors about anything else, no, she's at home. I don't know why people make up the weirdest shit, but no. Me and her FaceTimed last night. Eugenia is one of the sweetest people. She's such a real friend of mine. And yeah.
It's interesting that he's going in the opposite direction of the way he's been treating her for months. I mean, he has pretty much the same way he was treating Barb's last night on his life. Perhaps he just doesn't know how to be nice to his friends. But he snaps at them. He puts them in the back of the room. If she's your baby girl, why'd you put baby in the corner? Huh?
Everyone's dealing with their own life shit, you know?
It's our body, we can do what we want to. It's our house, we can love what we want to. It's our song.
Yes, Sunflower, Eugenia is doing fine. We talk every day, she just hasn't been live. And yeah, whatever she wants to talk about, she will. But yes, overall, my baby's doing fine. Thank you guys for asking.
She probably needs to buy a whole new wardrobe to try and get the age restriction off of her channel. Right? If that's her prime source of income, and it's directed at kids, which is why, in my opinion, she's a child predator. You're absolutely directing your material at children, which is why your room is decorated like a elementary school girl's room. And then you're wearing lingerie and going out in public like that too, in freezing weather in Connecticut during December. I don't think that his information is very helpful, in the sense that it doesn't talk about the age restriction. He basically doesn't want to broach the subject at all. Perhaps he just doesn't want to take responsibility for it, or be the spokesperson for what's going on with her, which is understandable. You know, these people do have like media teams, and they don't want to step on anybody's feet in regards to how to handle a situation, right? Okay, I'm gonna pull this one up too. This one's from Revoke, the other one was from Jaded.
Well, Eugenia Cooney has officially been off of the internet for 2 weeks now, and this is raising a lot of concern and a lot of speculation as to where she could be. Before we even get into this video, because it is going to be a heavy topic and I am going to be doing this with a heavy heart, I do want to give this disclaimer that this video is intended to provide an update on Eugenia Cooney's whereabouts, and it's going to be drawing on publicly available information. And
well, I would, okay, so I enjoy both of these channels quite a bit, but there is a high level of speculation going on in pushing forward any ideas behind this most likely hoax, because it doesn't look like the family has actually announced anything, and I'm sure that she would have had Deb as her emergency contact on all of her platforms. Because you can do the, like, for instance, on Facebook, you can, if you pass away, your family or whoever your contact is can turn your account into a memorial account. I'm sure that she had that set up, because she's obviously close with her mom. Her mom pretty much manages her. And so if something seriously wrong was going on, she would more than likely make some sort of public announcement. But if it's a matter of privacy, like she's trying to retool what her internet presence is going to look like since she's facing this restriction now, or maybe she's suffering from some depression from what happened. Who knows? But anyway, I wanted to play this one because Revoke actually reads this alleged obituary.
It's crucial to note that the details discussed in this video are going to be based on unverified sources and speculation within the public domain. I, as the content creator, cannot independently confirm or deny the accuracy of this information, but it is important to talk about. We are about to dive into this video, but I just want to give three quick key points. The information, one, is shared in this video is sourced from publicly available platforms, news articles, and social media. Two, due to the sensitivity and nature of this topic, the logistics of Eugenia Cooney's recent whereabouts, it cannot be fully confirmed, even though we have seen the things going on the internet and what they're saying. Three, now, I just want to say that I encourage you guys to approach this content with a critical mindset, understanding that the information provided may be speculative and subject to change. With that being said, let's talk about Eugenia and where she's been. 7 days ago, you guys, it says, Eugenia Cooney, 9 of Greenwich, Connecticut, passed away on January 7th, 2024 at LaPlace General Hospital in New York City, New York. I do want to say that when I do try...
And it's important to note that she got her age restriction somewhere around January 4th. That is the last time she did any live streams on TikTok.
I'd click off of this link. It's telling me that the page is not available, which means that it could be false information. And maybe that's why it is flagged and taken down. But this is at obituary.com. There has been other articles, from public informational sites on Nuke, and it gives out public information, including birth certificates and death records, and there is also one over there. But again, we have seen hoaxes in the past talking about Eugenia passed away because she's taken a break from social media, that it literally happened whenever she went on her big internet hiatus and seeked out recovery. So I want to sit here in the benefit that this could be another hoax and Eugenia could be actively just taking a break from social media. While this is public information, you guys can search up yourselves, and I highly encourage you, and I say this all the time, to form your own opinions and speculation and do your own independent research on objects that we discuss in the videos that I upload. With that being said, 2 months ago, I started this journey on YouTube. Really, I started this journey on TikTok, and I started uploading, talking about Eugenia Cooney and why I think she needs a help, and she should be taking a break from social media and actively seeking help, because I had stated I'm somebody who has known her from the YouNow days, and to see the state that she's in now, especially post-2019, it's very sad and critical for her. So when I started this journey to try to uncover more about her family, what could be going on in her everyday life, and just kind of put the puzzle pieces together to why Eugenia is Eugenia. I really think that Eugenia Cooney is the girl that the internet, not just the internet, the world failed. I really do. And I say that because even when she was, I hate all these people who try to say, well, she's an adult, she knows what she's doing. Okay, but what about when she was a child? Because she was streaming and it was visible then. Why wasn't Child Protective Services stepping in? And even...
Well, I agree with you there. However, that was 11 years ago, right? So shouldn't she have by now been able to get some therapy and some help? And like, at what point is she responsible for taking accountability for her own situation? You know, I'm a firm believer that nobody should carry their childhood baggage into their adulthood and make it, you know, hurt themselves or hurt others as a result of it, right? Whether it be they bring an eating disorder into adulthood, or they just become incredibly bitter to the people around them, and just keep talking about it over and over again. And that is something Eugenia kept doing, is talking about getting bullied in, like, junior high, I think, or early high school, and how she got pulled out of school because of it. Now, that seems unlikely to me that it was as bad as what she's talking about, because I personally experienced a lot of bullying as a kid as well. And like I said, I didn't carry that stuff into adulthood. I just reached out to people that I could make friends with. And it seems like she really struggled to actually relate to anybody. And maybe that's because she looks like she should be part of the popular crowd. And the popular crowd maybe pulled some Jeffree Star on her and didn't really want her around. Now, Jeffree Star can say she's my baby all he wants, but we've seen the way he treats her in person, and it's not nice at all, you know?
Even nowadays, why are her doctors saying she's okay? Medically, it's not. Sorry, I'm not medically speculating my opinion. I'm just saying, I feel like everybody, even the police officers, detectives who said, yeah, you're fine, like, just go home and... Ew, by the way, if something's wrong, just move an object in the background of your video and we'll know to come. I highly doubt that the detectives were sitting there watching a whole 12-hour stream.
Yeah, I feel like that's totally fake news. There's no possible way that the sergeant of the Special Victims Unit was watching her whole streams for a signal. Plus, she has cell phones in her room. She could have just called him if she needed him.
Very torn on the situation, and I don't really know what to believe, but I am going to be reading a public site that is called spiritparting.com, and this is titled Eugenia Sullivan Cooney Obituary, New Haven, Connecticut. American YouTuber and internet personality has passed. This article reads, Eugenia Sullivan Cooney obituary / passing. Our hearts go out to the family and friends of Eugenia Sullivan Cooney, an iconic American YouTuber and internet sensation whose infectious energy and originality enchanted audiences across the globe. Eugenia, whose birth name was Colleen Cooney and who was born in Massachusetts on July 27th, 1994, greatly impacted the lives of many who followed her journey, both online and off. This article does go on to talk about her YouTube career just a little bit, and then it says, a legacy of originality, tenacity, and heartfelt connection is what Eugenia Sullivan Cooney has left behind. Her influence on the internet content production community, is undeniable, touching the lives of both established and aspiring artists. Instead of flowers, the family would like donations to mental health organizations, which reflects the dedication, or Eugenia's dedication, to bringing attention to mental health issues. I pray that these offerings will always be there to help others as they seek healing and understanding of who they are. Now it wraps it up in this last paragraph, and it says, while we bid farewell to Eugenia Sullivan Cooney, let us rejoice in the happiness she brought to so many people's lives and the strength that she has gave to those who sought comfort in her online company. As of all who loved and admired her, may her memory always shine as a symbol of kindness and creativity. She gracefully stood the digital realm, and her legacy will shine brilliantly in eternity. May she rest in peace. Now, y'all.
The fact that the obituary says to just randomly donate to mental health organizations without specifically naming something specifically related to her eating disorder or something like that is eyebrow raising. And, you know, it's one of the first indicators to me that this is a fake. that this is a hoax. That and the fact that there are several other articles online that say she's alive. And so really these are the only two sources that feature these obituaries. But if you just simply Google her name, it comes up as with fact check corrections that no, she's alive. It's a hoax, right? Okay, let's continue.
All these articles that are talking about this, it seems, I don't know, there's so many different articles that are saying the same thing and giving the same dates and times. So there could be validity to it, and it could be possibly true. But who knows? She might just be taking a break from the internet, and the internet's just going crazy, and maybe people even made fake obituaries for her. Who?
If she had actually passed, there would be an article in Variety, because that's where the article about her having this relationship with the sergeant in her hometown, who is supposed to be watching her live streams for a symbol, that's where it would be published. It wouldn't just be random stuff like this, you know, that seems to be getting pulled down because it's probably a hoax, right?
Really knows, but I do want to bring this up and talk about it with you guys today. With all these articles like floating around the internet, and people are picking up on it, people are starting to talk about it. There's so many articles that are being made on Reddit and Quora talking about this. So I feel like if she would see this, she or somebody in the family would come out and be like, no, like, she's fine. Like, this is all just a hoax. Like, literally, she's fine. But the fact that nobody has said anything, and it's been another week since it was uploaded. Who knows? Maybe she is seeking treatment or recovery right now, and maybe that's why she is on this internet hiatus that she's been on. And maybe that's why, because she's been away for so long, maybe that's why these articles are starting to float around in speculation. But if this is true, there's a couple words I want to have with Deb right now, who's probably never going to see this video, but you guys will. And I'm going to be talking to her from mother to mother. I have a kid, and I couldn't imagine not being a parent for my child, no matter what age that they become. Because you signed up for this when you had your kids. Whether you adopted Eugenia or had her yourself, you signed up for it. I don't know if you're delusional yourself. I think you are, but to feed into this delusional world that your daughter had or has, who knows what's going on right now, it's incredibly sickening. And I hope you have eternal nightmares from failing your kid. Wrapping this up, I think it was a little bit off for the family and the article to be saying, if this article was true, again, it's just something on the internet, so it could be a hoax. That the family said they want people to send donations to mental health organizations. That's nice, but where was that energy for your daughter? You couldn't invest in a mental health organization for her? Well, you guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this video here because I am making it with a heavy heart, and I don't necessarily know if this is true or not, but I did want to share this information with you guys for y'all to be on the lookout. If this lady appears again on live, or if she comes up from the woodwork and says she is out, you know, going to take a break from the internet for so long, I want you guys to jump back in the comment section and update me and let me know.
Yeah, I think she has done this before, just sort of disappeared, even though she was always saying, I'm online every day, right? I go live every day, I think is what she would say repeatedly through her live streams. But the game has changed for her, because she can't target kids anymore. So the game has changed. Now, if she was in treatment and didn't really have internet access right now, because usually they take away your devices at least for the first 3 days, and they restrict your access, especially if she's suffering from depression, right? Then Jeffrey lied to us about FaceTiming with her on Saturday night. But who knows? I mean, I don't find the guy very trustworthy, so I don't know that I can believe anything out of his mouth. But yeah, it did look like he picked up his phone and texted to find out if some information. I don't know that he got his text back, you know? I don't know that he got a text back, but who knows? I'm sure that if this is real, Variety is going to be the one reporting on it. That's my guess.